2018. It was so much, so extra, so grande. Cave rescue, royal wedding, the people we lost, another World Cup and Winter Olympics in the books. We launched a car into space, and we discovered Yanny, or Laurel, depending on who you ask. And that's just a tiny fraction of what happened in 2018. But without a doubt, 2018 was also a big year with climate change. So we're here to catch you up on some climate stories you might have missed this year. It's our climate change rewind, so to speak. But don't worry, this video doesn't include Fortnite, or K-pop, or Will Smith. We said no Fortnite references. Here's a few reasons 2018 was a pivotal year for one of the most complex challenges humanity's ever faced. Let's start it off with some broken records. In 2018, global carbon dioxide emissions rose 3%, reaching 37 billion tons of CO2, a new all-time high for a single year. This year, scientists saw our planet's atmospheric CO2 concentrations surpass 411 parts per million. Passing 411 parts per million marks a new record high. This is not great news. 2018 was also one of the hottest years ever, and that's not a coincidence. This is part of a very warm trend. The last 5 years were the hottest ever recorded by humans. But 2018 also saw the hottest daily low temperature ever recorded in Oman. Now, in June there, the mercury never dipped below 108.7 degrees Fahrenheit. Oh, man. Oman, get it? There were a whopping 8,000 different wildfires in California this year. The plants have been drying out due mainly to the warmer temperatures, drought conditions, and changing weather patterns. And 2018 also had the deadliest U.S. wildfire in a century and the most destructive wildfire ever in California. The innocuously named Campfire completely consumed a town named Paradise, killing more than 85 people and causing up to $10 billion in damage. Oceans hit record high temperatures. They were hotter in 2018 than they've been since we started measuring ocean heat back in 1940. Because water takes up more space when it's warmer and the world's glaciers are melting, the oceans are higher too. Sea level has risen on average between 2 and 3 millimeters compared to 2017. Doesn't sound like much, but keep that up for a century and you're looking at oceans a foot higher than today. Warmer oceans and hotter air temperatures also help supercharge storms around the globe. The Northern Hemisphere cyclone season was more active than usual, including storms like Jebi, the strongest typhoon to make landfall in Japan since 1993, Mangkhut, which caused the strongest storm surge in Hong Kong since 1953, and Michael, the strongest hurricane to hit the US mainland since 1969. In October, the UN released a bombshell report warning that we need to limit global warming to just 1.5 degrees Celsius compared to temperatures before the Industrial Revolution if we want to avoid devastating consequences. As the report puts it, meeting the 1.5 degree target will require, quote, rapid, far-reaching, and unprecedented changes in all aspects of society. That translates to the world cutting our carbon emissions in half by 2030 and reaching net zero around 2050. The US government also published its own report listing in gruesome detail how climate change is already wreaking havoc, sucking money, and costing lives in every part of the United States, as well as what America can do to avoid the even worse damage still in store. Now, the congressionally mandated report was released by the White House on the Friday afternoon after Thanksgiving, which many people think was an attempt to downplay and hide the findings. That math checks out. In December, the world's national governments met in Poland for the 24th Conference of the Parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Catchy title, but we can call it COP24 for short. Representatives from nearly 200 countries agreed on a rulebook that lays out how every country that signed on to the 2015 Paris Climate Agreement will measure and report their efforts to cut emissions. That's great news. But even if every country meets their Paris commitment, the world is still predicted to warm by 3 degrees Celsius, so many people are already calling for bigger commitments. Ireland and Israel both announced that they won't allow the sale of gasoline or diesel cars beyond 2030, joining a number of other countries that have said they'll ban cars with internal combustion engines. I guess this means that the waiting list for a Tesla isn't going to get shorter anytime soon. New Zealand announced that they won't allow any new offshore exploration for oil and gas within their coastal waters. It only affects new oil and gas drilling, not existing projects, but the decision is part of the country's long-term transition towards a carbon-neutral future. And it's one of the most significant moves by any country when it comes to limiting fossil fuel extraction. New Zealand, home to hobbits and sensible climate policy. In 2018, more and more businesses and local governments made commitments to use 100% clean energy. They include over 100 companies, 100 US cities, one major US utility, and two US states, one of which, California, is the fifth largest economy in the world. Oh, and one more thing. And this is a much smaller story, but in 2018, we launched this show. We are grateful to make these videos for you, and we hope that you've enjoyed learning about the challenges that we face and how to fix this hot mess. These are just some of the stories of climate change from 2018, and you can learn a lot more about them by clicking the links down in the description. And here's one thing you can do to help solve climate change right now. Share our videos with everyone you know. Subscribe to Hot Mess for more awesome climate videos, and become a supporter on Patreon to help us keep making them. Here's to next year. Thanks for watching. Hey guys, thanks for watching our latest video. We hope you consider subscribing. Maybe click that little bell icon so that you get notified when we have a new video. And check out our Patreon page where you can help us not only make more videos, but make them even more carbon neutral and good for the climate than any other YouTube channel.